Okay, there's more diving to come, but immediately now we're going to get back to wrestling. Pittsburgh's Curt Angle in the final at 220 pounds. No American has ever won this weight class at a fully contested Olympic Games. Angle is with a new club named after the late Dave Schultz, revered in the wrestling community. Schultz, as you know, was murdered in January. Angle wrestled against Iran's Abbas Jadidi. The score was tied at the end of regulation. We're going to pick it up now in overtime, and once again, Jeff Blatnick and Russ Hellickson.
220 pounds for the gold medal. Curt Angle of the United States in the red singlet. Abbas Jadidi of Iran in the blue singlet. And we're knotted at 1-1 just into the overtime. 3 minutes. One of the wrestlers must score at least 3 points for it to end early. 3 minutes elapsed. We get to that 8-minute mark. The referees will decide.
Jadidi scored first with an ankle lace to go up 1-0, and Angle scored a takedown but not the score. 2.5 minutes now left in overtime.
Curt Angle having lots of reasons to be motivated for this competition. He wants to do it for his mom. She's raised him. He still lives with her. His father died in a construction accident. Very close. It inspires him to compete. And he's wrestling also for David Schultz, who was slain about 6 months ago. World and Olympic champion. He wrestles for the Dave Schultz Wrestling Club right now. So he wants to win this one for a lot of reasons. He's the defending world champion in his weight division. Attempted a shot, but he rotates it out of bounds. I don't think there'll be a call.
Should
now it's
call.
1-1.
Angle was able to turn himself back towards the center of the mat. And deflect Jadidi's shot out of bounds. He wasn't driven out of bounds under attack, thus no call there, but look for a passive call perhaps quickly against Angle for Jadidi's efforts. The referees look for risk-taking, look for aggressiveness, and Jadidi here has been very aggressive in the overtime. That's his third straight shot on Angle.
And Angle doing a good job of rotating it back to the center. If he were to back out, he would get called. He could lose the point here. Right now, wrestling intensity. Conditioning should be a factor in this match. Both wrestlers have really expended and extended themselves in this match despite the 1-1 score.
Jadidi showing a lot of power in this overtime.
Off the mat. No points, no score. 1 minute and 25 seconds left in the sudden death. Jackie, Curt's mom, very nervous. Sometimes she leaves. She gets so nervous and anxious, but she's going to stay here for this one.
And Jadidi here.
Taking a break.
Taking a break. He expended an awful lot of energy in those last three or four attempted offensive moves on Curt Angle. He comes right back and does it again.
Jadidi making a lot of shots in this match, and the arm up by the referee, that will be a passivity call. The second one in this match against Curt Angle. It can be a factor in this match.
So far, both wrestlers have two passive calls against them. We have another minute and 15 seconds left in this overtime. If it remains tied 1-1, it'll come down to the passive calls. And if they are tied, it is a referee's decision.
On the leg, ankle length, it's tight. This could be a problem.
Well, as long as Angle hangs on to Jadidi's ankle here,
he's going to pick it up.
No points there, and Angle able to defend.
A lot of power there and fight by both wrestlers. A tremendous matchup of talent here at 220 pounds.
And they're letting it go an awful long time for Jadidi to work, but there's the whistle. Back to the standing position. 38 seconds left. 1-1 score. Two passive calls against each wrestler.
Curt Angle carries a picture of his father in a wallet his father gave him.
And a shot by Angle's got the angle of Jadidi. He could score a takedown. He needs to get his head up and to the side.
He thinks he's already gotten the point. He needs to make something happen here. It's still 1-1. 20 seconds remaining. No points given yet by the referee or Matt Judge or Matt Chairman. He needs to make an adjustment here. 10 seconds to go. They're going to call him back to their feet, Jeff. They may let this go to the very end.
They should have let this go because Angle took the risk.
He thinks he scored. That's why he's laying there. Jeff, time runs out.
If anything, that bodes well for Kurt Angle because he had the last offensive shot and it was the most threatening. Two passive calls apiece. Well, how would the referees decide this?
This is as tight as it can possibly get. It is now in the hands of the referee, Matt Judge, Matt Chairman, to make a decision. The outcome totally in question, but Kurt Angle was the more aggressive at the end of this match, Jeff.
Okay.
What will be the outcome? They can't decide.
And it's going to be Kurt Angle.
Kurt Angle of the United States.
Russ, it couldn't have been any closer. Two passive calls apiece. The score tied 1-1. It came down to a referee's decision, and Angle had the last shot. That might have been the turning point in this referee's decision. A hard-fought match by both.
Well, it won't get any closer or more dramatic than that anywhere. Kurt Angle is crying, Jeff. Everything has been spent here. The moment of truth. He said in an interview after the 95 World Championships when he won, they asked him what he was going to do, and he said, I'm going to go to 96, go for the gold in Atlanta for my father. And he did it.
Well, his inspirations carried him through the toughest match of his life. It couldn't have been any closer.
There's the hand being raised. The referees didn't know. First raised one hand, then the other, and elated. Kurt Angle jumps for joy with this victory and gold medal. And let's go to John Dockery with our winner.
What can you say about this moment?
I've worked for this moment all my life. I can't believe it happened.
I saw you kneel on the mat and pray. Were you talking to your dad?
Oh yeah, my dad's always with me. Dave Schultz, my Uncle Fred, my aunt, my grandmother. They're all together pulling for me, rooting for me up there. And I know it came down to that. I knew they were with me. I wasn't sure if I won. This is the best thing that's ever happened to me. I can't believe this. All I wanted to do is win a world championship and an Olympic gold medal. And I did them both. If I died tonight, I'd be the happiest man in the world. I love you, Mom. I did that one for you.
What did you say to your dad?
I just said thanks, Dad, for watching over me. He's always there. There's no doubt about it. I love him so much. I really do.
Congratulations, you're the world champion and now you're Olympic gold medalist. Congrats.
Well, a lot of love and a lot of fight, and it's going to net you one Olympic gold medal. Kurt Angle, our champion at 220 pounds.
I love you, America. How you doing, Pittsburgh? I love you.
Quite a scene out at the wrestling venue tonight, an emotional Kurt Angle, and he will be with us in less than an hour toward the end of our broadcast tonight. He'll talk with us in the studio. When we come back, we'll head back out to the pool. More of the springboard diving finals to come. Welcome back once more. Earlier, you saw Kurt Angle defeat Iran's Abbas Jadidi by a referee's decision in wrestling. Angle entered the match, inspired perhaps, and perhaps pushed as well, by the memory of his late father, who died about a decade ago in a construction accident, and Dave Schultz, his coach and training partner. Schultz, as you know, a revered figure in wrestling, murdered earlier this year under truly tragic circumstances. Angle surely had his father and his ex-coach in mind as he went to the medal podium, spent after an amazing battle with Jadidi. These his first moments as an Olympic champion. This is Kurt Angle's mother, Marie, and he is going to come over to her and place the gold medal around her neck. There you see it. As I mentioned earlier, his father, Dave, died in a construction accident in 1985. There's Kurt with his mom, and we're back now in the studio. What was going through your mind? So many emotions tied up with victory in the Olympic Games.
Well, it's been the hardest road to victory. I've had my ups and downs. I've trained hard. I've gotten ready for this, and it finally came. And it's really hard to take in right now. I can't believe it's actually over and that I've done it.
You're from Pittsburgh. You have, what, five brothers and sisters?
Yes.
A close-knit family. Your coach and training partner was Dave Schultz, so that's almost part of an extended family. And, of course, he was murdered earlier this year.
Well, it was a tragic ending to somebody that had such a brilliant career. Dave was my mentor. He's my idol. I did whatever he did, you know. He's somebody that I looked up to, and I wanted to be very much alike.
Was your dad an athlete?
My dad was an athlete. Sports were very important to him. He was probably my biggest fan. He went to every sporting event that I was in. So I know he was watching over me tonight.
You carry a picture of your dad in a wallet he gave you, right?
Yeah, I also carry a sweatshirt with me when I'm going to competitions. It's in the studio here. I always carry it with me.
This was some battle with Jadidi tonight, and it was very close. In every tiebreaker, it was dead even, and it came down to the referee's decision, and it even appeared like he couldn't decide. At first, I thought he was going to raise Jadidi's hand.
Well, what happened is the wrestler, Jadidi, tried to raise his own hand. And the referee was trying to keep it down. So,
but these are strong guys.
Oh, it scared the heck out of me. I thought he won. I thought the referees picked him, and I was starting to feel the agony of defeat. But then he raised my hand, and I knew right then I won. I knew I deserved the win. I knew it was coming down to the decision, and I believed in my heart that I won. And, you know, God was looking over me, and everything went into place.
For those who don't pay much attention to wrestling, and we're not talking about the WWF here, folks. We're into real wrestling outside the context of the Olympic Games. They might find it surprising that guys who are by nature aggressive get called a couple of times for what's referred to as passivity. Explain
right,
that.
Right. Well, passivity means that you're not aggressive, you're stalling. And by getting a passivity, that could be a bad mark if you end up in a tie. And what happened is we tied in passivities. He had two, I had two. So they went down to who made more aggressive moves. It came down to six for me and four for him. So I won by decision of referees by aggressive moves.
Let's go back to Dave Schultz. He was an important figure in the life, not only of Kurt Angle, but many U.S. wrestlers. One of the great figures in wrestling in this country. What has been the reaction of your fellow competitors since January, since his murder?
Well, I think everybody was in shock at first because it's just hard to fathom that Dave Schultz will never wrestle again. He was one of the best wrestlers in the United States in the history of it. And, you know, he had some more years in front of him. So it was really hard for everybody to accept it. But, you know, Dave's memory will always be in everybody. I don't think that anybody could forget about him. He'll definitely be in my heart. He's been in my heart, and I know he's watching over me, too.
Now, this is a point that we've made earlier in the Olympic Games, but perhaps it bears repeating. With a few exceptions, the tennis stars, the Dream Team players, the top track and field athletes, almost all Olympians labor in obscurity for 4 years, and then you make a quantum leap from virtual obscurity to the grandest stage, billions of people watching worldwide, millions of people in America, packed houses. This is everything.
It definitely is everything, and it's such a short period of time. You know, you're starting out 4 years of training, hard work, and it all comes down to 2 days. It just doesn't make sense. You know, professional athletes, they have multiple games every year. So if they have a bad game, they can say, oh, I can get it back next week, or I can do better next tomorrow or the next week or whenever their competition is. Here, it's every 4 years. You got to be ready. And that's what makes an amateur athlete so special.
Let's look 4 years ahead. You'll be 28 in December. So you'd be nearly 32 years old if you went to Sydney in the year 2000. What about it?
I haven't thought of it right now. I fulfilled my dreams, but, you know, it's hard for me to leave the sport. It's been with me for so long, and I've put a lot of blood, sweat, and tears into it, and I don't know if I can just leave it. It'll always be with me, whether I'm a coach or an athlete, but it's going to be really hard for me to accept a retirement. I'm thinking about it. I'm going to give it a few more months, and then I'll make a decision.
Curt Angle from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. You're entitled to think it over. You don't have to do anything except savor tonight's gold medal. Congratulations.
Thanks a lot, Bob.
Okay, and we'll be back to Atlanta when we continue with our coverage of the Centennial Olympic Games in just a few moments.
An exciting night for the United States in freestyle wrestling in the gold medal match in the 220-pound class. Curt Angle of the United States and Abbas Jadidi of Iran ended in a hard-fought 1-1 tie. Angle dedicating his effort here to the father he lost 11 years ago. Judges began to sort through a variety of criteria to separate the two. When the referee moved to raise the victor's hand, it at first appeared that the decision had gone to Jadidi. But no, on a 2-1 vote by the judges, Angle had won it. An emotional gold medal for Angle, with nearly 300 friends and family in attendance all the way from Pittsburgh.